Friends, are you tired of brownouts? I know that I am. Why, there's nothing more that I hate than having a brownout in the morning before breakfast or just after a good hearty lunch or even around supper time. Why, it just messes up your whole day. That's why I want to show you a way to take good care of them brownouts with this genuine special high voltage amp sine wave UPS battery backup system. And I bet you thought I was talking about something else, didn't you?
Welcome to New Things, New Tech. I'm Scott Drudge. If you live somewhere that has lots of storms, you might suffer from brownouts or full-blown power outages for a few seconds to a few minutes or even longer. This can be killer to your network and computer systems, especially when you do work from home like I do. There's nothing like getting a brownout right in the middle of an online meeting. It takes what seems like forever to get the firewall and network back up and running. Sure, a generator would be nice for those long power outages, but for just those normal dips in powers, one or two nice UPS system backups like this one here can really save the day. So let's pull this thing out and see what we've got.
Yeah, this thing's heavy. Alrighty. Well, we'll start like this.
So this is an APC UPS BR-1500 MS 1500 volt amp sine wave UPS. No, not that UPS. It stands for uninterruptible power supply. So it's a battery backup and a surge protector in one package. Alright, so we've got a manual and an F connector. Another little cable there.
This up. Okay, here we go.
Time to get a little nerdy. So, this BR-1500 MS has 10 outlets, 6 are battery backup with surge protection, and 4 are surge protection only. Automatic voltage regulation instantly corrects the low-high voltage fluctuations and is an active PFC compatible. This particular unit has a sine wave output. Sine wave UPS is optimized performance for higher end electronics. Basically, it means it produces less heat, gives you a cleaner power feed that is better for any device that may not work well on standard backups. Things like maybe your monitor, router, firewall, or maybe even a light are some examples. And for some strange reason, if you want to play video games while you are having a power outage, then a sine wave backup unit is much better for your Xbox, PS2, or other gaming device. How long will this UPS run stuff? The top of the box gives us some runtime comparisons with different models of their UPSs. For example, if you run a 42-inch LCD television plus a gaming console, you'll be using around 335 watts, which gives you about 21 minutes on this unit, or on their BR-1000 MS, 10 minutes, or 14 minutes on the BR-1350 MS. For practical use, running my PC with my 40-inch monitor, the cable modem, firewall, and router, I'll probably get about 32 minutes, I think, like suggested on this line here. If you really scale back what you've got connected, then you can get up to 150 minutes. But that really means you're using only a measly 40 watts of power. Regardless, it gives you time to save documents and gracefully shut down your computer without the harsh impact on your electronics from a sudden power loss. Enough of this tech stuff. Let's get this thing fired up. Included with every APC UPS is a receipt-like printout indicating the testing done to make sure that this is the best you can get. This certifies that this unit was actually in really good shape when it went out the door. First thing we need to do is open up the backup and connect the battery. If you look at this yellow sticker here, it actually gives us 5 steps that we need to do first before we can actually start using this unit. So I'll go ahead and peel that off. So peeling off this sticker. And I can take off the pass-fail sticker. So to open this up, I'm going to push down like that. open this up. This says pull up here, like so. What you have here is the red connection plug there, which needs to be connected to this. All right, so connect that up. And set this back in there. And then close the unit back up. Make sure we're in nice and snug. Oh. There are little grooves for this thing to slide right on nice and neat. Here we go. This thing is ready to fire up. Oh yeah, the other thing we want to do is make sure we peel off this front protective coating. Now we're ready to go install this thing. So somewhere in the closet where most of the stuff sits is where we're going to install this. I think I'm going to use this for keeping the PFSense firewall running, the cable modem, the switch, one of the Wi-Fi routers, and maybe my main PC. Should be enough for all of these for a short time.
Well, it looks like the total I can put into this battery backup is a total of 7, so that means I can plug my still in. Oh, and I can't plug the refrigerator in because the 5 and the 4 is greater than the 7. So the most I can put in is maybe my still. Go plug it in there. And that cable modem can fit, that's a total. That totals up to 4 and 1. I got a 5 in the firewall. That's a 2. That means we're getting a total of 7. That's the most I can run.
So this APC backup has some really nice features on it. If you hit the power button on the front panel when it's plugged in, you can see that it's actually online here, that it's got full battery power, and the load that's actually occurring right now. Right now I've got the alarm turned off. So under this, it's expecting that the total load is going to be 284 watts with everything that's plugged into it right now. So let's go ahead and hook up some devices to this battery backup and see what kind of a load it can handle. So the battery backup is on the mains right now with a 0 watt load on it. It's at full power and has no load showing on the load indicator either. So the first thing I'm going to connect is this 15.5 watt LED light bulb. So this bulb can run for 179 minutes, drawing a 12 watt load, which is about 1% of what the battery capacity is. So next, I'm gonna go ahead and plug in this monitor that's off screen here, just can't see. This monitor over here is an old Acer monitor. It's roughly 180 watts. Yeah, it's a beast. This monitor's draw is about 27 watts, which is about 3% of the load that this battery can handle, for a total of 153 minutes of runtime. Next, if I plug in, say, my Dell laptop is 65 watts. So the laptop can go for 296 minutes, drawing a 12 watt load and about 1% of the load. Let's plug in something fun here. I've got this old SwinTech 1186 typewriter. You never know when you might want to start typing while you're, you know, have no lights on battery backup. If I power up this guy, the typewriter is 72 watts. It shows that it'll pull about 19 watts sitting idle. If you're actually typing on it, it jumps it up to about 40 watts. It's a 2% draw and can run for about 186 minutes. Now for lots of fun, this over here is an old Mac Pro. This old Mac Pro is 302 to 900 watts. So this should throw it over the limit. Let's see if I get a plug here. So just for kicks, we put a Mac Pro running on this battery backup, can go for approximately 16 minutes, has a total load of 275 watts, which is about 30% of this battery backup's capacity. So all four devices are hooked up and it looks like the total time is about 13 minutes. The total draw of all four devices works out to be about 328 watts, which is 36% capacity of this battery. So even though this is a 900 watt rated unit, when you're drawing between 300 and 900 watts on the computer itself or the total of all your devices, you're gonna run down the amount of time that you can actually keep this thing up and running. Should be long enough for you to actually shut things down. The battery backup is installed in the closet where the PFSense firewall, 24-port switch, and cable modem live, and they are all connected to the battery backup side of the UPS. Total power consumption is about 58 watts. With that load alone, I should be able to get about 2 hours of runtime. Also connected to the battery backup side is the Linksys mesh Wi-Fi router, which adds in another 5 to 6 watts. So now we're looking at about 64 watts for a runtime of a little under 2 hours. When I've added in my Ryzen 9 MSI gaming computer, that adds in another 240 watts for a total of about 300 watts. That knocks our runtime down to about 25 minutes. Ideally, I'd shut down the Ryzen computer and Visio monitor and just use my iPad, laptop, or phone for the best results, since all of those would have their own, hopefully charged, battery power. But you can plug in USB-C or USB-2 power devices in the front of this backup unit as well. UPS can automatically shut down whatever computer it's connected to using the Powerchute software on the Windows, or the Mac can use its own energy saving option found under the system preferences. Just connect a UPS cable and follow the Mac instructions in the link below. If on Windows, then installing the Powerchute app from the APS website works best with the latest version. See the link below in the description. The Powerchute will inform you of any events that have occurred to cause bad power. This takes a little time to get some stats in here. You can also see an event counter on the backup screen. The current status screen gives you some basic information about your power consumption and battery time remaining. I like this part here where it says you're currently using 297 watts. You can connect more stuff to your battery backup. But just keep in mind, the more you connect to the battery side is just going to reduce how long the backup stuff will run. The self-test section allows you to test your battery backup powering the devices connected. The software will essentially disconnect the mains and run a test to see how well things are working on battery. You could simply unplug the UPS and check the UPS status screens to see how it's working. There's additional fluff pages in here to show your energy usage. These take time to populate, but give you an idea of your environmental impact. Down under the options, I have the sound turned off because backup units, smoke detectors, and other alarms just scare the heck out of the dogs, and are just annoying anyway, in my opinion. Under the runtime section, you can set when you want the UPS to shut off your computer, if connected to the backup. The sensitivity screen allows you to set when the backup unit switches to battery and back to mains. By default, it's set to minimum, but most should be able to leave it set to high. If you live somewhere where your power levels fluctuate a lot, then you might want to set it to medium or low. Try the high setting first, and then work your way down if the event levels seem pretty high on a regular basis. Overall, for my needs, this backup will be a great addition. This will smooth out the occasional brownouts that occur during storms and keep the network up and running during longer power outages. For you, get as big of a backup unit as you can afford, then spend a little more than you can afford and get a better one.
Thanks for watching. Remember, if you need a good fix and for your brownouts, then you need to get yourself one of them here backup units. It'll make sure your day is a whole lot better. Make sure to subscribe and ring that bell. Why, if you have one of these here UPS backups, you can do it even while you're having a power problem.